Yes, welcome back to Entrepreneurship Tuesday, and this is our first interview of the day. Before I introduce my guest, remember we have a question on Facebook, and the question is, do you think social media has provided business opportunities for the youth or imiwaribu kitabia? So tell us what you think about this on Facebook, and yes, we'd like to, let me just switch this. For now, we'd like to get your views, your comments and suggestions about this social media issue. But without much further ado, I'd like to introduce my guest of the day. And this guy has 5 years experience in photography and film, and he goes by the name Gibson. Karibu sana. All right, your camera is number four. So just in case I missed anything, you can add on to that while you introduce yourself.
Yes, like you say, I've been there before, but 5 years of professional experience. The other years are basically amateur, or learning from other people that have been there in the industry and growing myself to an extent that I can come to be able to be there in the limelight. So yes, I'm a branding expert also at Peak Performance and co-founded of GNG Creations, which is basically a video marketing platform for each and every individual that wants to rise in that capacity.
All right, so GNG co-founder and creation and branding expert at Peak Performance International.
Yeah.
These are two independent companies.
Yes.
All right. Do you have people that, do you have other people at GNG that also work with Peak Performance?
GNG is a different company on its own that has given me an opportunity to be an expert of branding at Peak Performance and many other companies. All Peak Performance is there basically because we have a longer time with them, that they have seen the work that I've done in GNG, and that's what I'm doing with them.
You're
coming
doing
into a partnership. Yep.
So you're one person with 24 hours in a day. How do you split yourself?
How we basically split, GNG Creations, most of the times I grew. For the 5 years I was alone, together with the person that we founded it, but basically she's not into photography so much, but she was my director then. So she also opened another branch under that, which, because GNG Creations, when it comes to creations, it means creativity. Not only photography and video, but also interior design and deco. So we wanted it to be opened up to people, and young, more so young people that can be out there and want to tap into their potential and their creativity and get money. So we give them the umbrella, the creative part, in order for them to be able to monetize their potential.
So creativity is the keyword at GNG?
Creativity is the keyword.
So you guys are looking to grow into other forms of creativity as well?
We're looking to grow into other forms of creativity because we saw we can limit ourselves into video and film, but at the same time, there are people out there that they are very good in structures, background, architectural. And since we have a background of that, more so my co-founder, she has a background of that, it was possible for us to mentor people and to be able to monetize their passion.
All right, so what is your background yourself in education?
In education, I did journalism, print journalism for that matter.
Print journalism.
I should be writing magazines.
You should be writing magazines and articles and everything.
And articles,
do you write still?
Once in a while I do write more so what we call marketing articles, because in the field that I'm in, I'm including so much what I learned in class. But at the same time, I didn't take the news line so much, which I was expected to take. Yep.
So you found yourself picking up a camera.
Learning all the basic things that there need to be known. And then I found a gap in the industry because most of the times when it comes to, I really needed fast money. There is no way I had come out of school and struggled paying school fees. So I really needed a way not become a burden when I come out of school. So I, when in our industry, most of the times before we go all through and become a senior reporter, I saw this guy can be tricky for me, and I will take that longer period for me to be able to get out there, because personally I was not so much interested into a lot of writing. So I felt, what is the best way and what is the interest that I have? During my period in school, I got a passion for camera. So I started, looking at people out there that have done something with the camera mm-hmm. and actually monetizing it, and I saw this is a very good opportunity. Mm-hmm. So I went to a place where it's not offered at our home in background in Tala, the eastern part of mm-hmm. the region. Mm-hmm. Whatever was being offered there was limited. Mm-hmm. I saw a gap mm-hmm. and I tapped into the gap. Mm-hmm. And I made sure that I've started doing videos from each, of course we started with the events video, mm-hmm. which is the consistent one, which mm-hmm. can give you fast money. Mm-hmm. But with time I grew to even branding churches, mm-hmm. to branding other companies that there, branding shops, mm-hmm. giving them a look and an image that mm-hmm. was not found in that particular place. And that is what surfaced me into what I'm doing right now.
All right, so you're based in Tala? That is what?
No, I'm not based in Tala. Uh-huh. I'm in town.
You're based in town?
Yes.
But this is where you started?
That's where I saw a gap there. In uh-huh. Nairobi, people had mushroomed. They were, uh-huh. they were the likes of Media Joss. Uh-huh. The likes, I think also the other guest is coming here, had uh-huh. taken the industry uh-huh. by a storm, which our people have learned from. Uh-huh. So I saw, how can I transfer this? Uh-huh. Because the competition was so much, uh-huh. and at the same time, I was growing. Mm-hmm. So I had to look for a gap and mm-hmm. also get a better gap where I came from. All so right. that's where I saw, and I saw this is a thing I can tap into and I can grow even in order for me to come and compete with other competitors in the city.
How did you land your first client?
Actually, it was because I gave him a low budget. Uh-huh. I was so desperate to get out there into the market.
Was this a trick that you were using, or was this a technique?
Yes, actually, I started my, because mostly when you come into this field, packaging mm-hmm. matters a lot. Mm-hmm. And since I did not know how to package myself, but that time I really didn't need packaging. I needed a business to come my way. Mm-hmm. So what happened is that after they had seen people, it was a wedding, mm-hmm. after they had seen people, different people that have come with their packages and what they're offering and their work, what they have done. Mm-hmm. So they decided, because a friend told me, just go and present yourself. When I went there, I asked from the committee, mm-hmm. How many people have presented? And told me so and so, ta da da da. And so, how much, what is their budget? Mm-hmm. And I said, okay, let me just give them a little bit minimum mm-hmm. because I can pinpoint the same things that these guys have presented uh-huh. and lower the budget. So, uh-huh. for me, it was more or less of a trick. Uh-huh. And at the same time, I looked at the market that I was also serving, because uh-huh. I could not give them a budget uh-huh. the same way I'm giving them in the city. Uh-huh. So, I look at these guys and look at their potential and I look at something that they can give.
Right.
And of course, not go losses to my accent,
all
of which
these,
I went
all
a loss.
All these factors that you put into account back then, taking the business back to Tala, where the competition is less stiff, giving your first client a lesser budget or a lower budget. Where did you learn all these things?
Basically, I have a background of entrepreneurship. Uh-huh. I've learned to grow in doing business. Uh-huh. It's only that I never landed in something specific that I'm passionate about. Uh-huh. So I've been able, I studied the market, I studied uh-huh. what people needed. In fact, there's a time in school, I used to sell rubbers uh-huh. in high school. Uh-huh. So there's a time I went and I actually, when it was time to go home, uh-huh. I found myself even selling the ones that I have, you uh-huh. know. People came, kuna rabo kali, wambia, unaweza chukua na ilikuwa midterm, so tunaenda home. So I went with slippers.
All right.
So it's something that I grew
so
with.
So you've always been a hustler.
I've really tried out hard to be out there. Yeah.
So you found your passion in photography and film, and this has become your hustle now.
This has become my hustle. Mm-hmm. I started intensely with weddings, which I still do, mm-hmm. events, funerals, these are mm-hmm. things that it's easy money that you can get, mm-hmm. and at the same time, if you have a good rapport mm-hmm. and you can package and present yourself well, mm-hmm. you can tap into that. But now, having an opportunity to see what is happening and where we are going, I tapped mm-hmm. first into the digital market, and then I also came into what we call video marketing, which mm-hmm. is something that is lacking in corporate. Mm-hmm. So that's what I'm focusing right
that
now.
That is what you're focusing
as the GNG Creations, I'm raising other people that can be able to do their weddings. Mm-hmm. Because most of the times you'll find yourself in more than two events in one Saturday.
All right.
Yep.
You have a foot in branding and marketing now.
Yes.
Since you're a visual artist,
yep.
You can brand and you can market. And you have a background in journalism.
Yep.
And this is somewhere you learn a lot of PR.
Yes.
All right. So do you think people understand the difference between marketing and PR?
Basically, people don't really understand the difference between marketing and PR. Mm-hmm. most of them, they have come to join it together, which because of lack of personnel, you might put it at that, because not many companies will have a public relationship officer, at the same time have a marketing executive. So they want somebody that has that completely, which can overwhelm. But now the difference comes in where marketing, you have to generate sales. PR, you have to keep the image. And you, the image is what will bring the market, because there are people specifically because of what
just
you have represented.
Take you back to the difference again. Just let people understand. Marketing is where you need to always improve sales and maintain, or improve or maintain sales.
Improve and increase sales.
Improve and increase sales.
Yes.
PR is where you maintain the image,
the brand itself.
The company itself, the product that you're selling.
Exactly.
All right, so people have come to match the two.
Yes. All people right. have come to merge the two. You find they are at the same time, they are trying to maintain the image, at the same time
they're trying to market.
They're trying to market, which most of the times what happens, the sales go down.
It dilutes the other.
All right. Because there are companies that have run for long with their image, but they have not maintained the clients and the sales. So they are, what they're doing is that they are marketing with their own image, but that will not generate a lot of leads and sales, because you'll be just dealing with your own clients, the people that know you. If you want to go far, you have to extend the base and have people that are marketing and also now tap more so into the digital marketing world.
All right, yes, and this is where you come in.
This is where I'm coming.
So you have knowledge in all this. You have knowledge in marketing, branding, and PR.
Yep.
I'd like to take you back to branding now. What is the importance of branding? Say I'm a shopkeeper. I own a shop and I sell simple stuff like milk or yogurt. Yes. What is the importance of branding for me?
Branding, mostly the importance of it is you maintain a consistent message that it will sink in the minds of people. I'm going to give you a good example with either Coca-Cola and Safaricom. In the next like 2 meters, you'll find a Safaricom shop. Same text, same color, everything almost the same, to an extent of which if you see me in green, you'll think of Safaricom. That is the image that it has created. Actually, there's a color that has come up that's called Safaricom Green. Because it's that particular green. It has dominated the market to an extent of which that people know the image. The importance of branding is that where we are going is, if you're not seen so much, people will forget about you. There's nothing as bad. It's better you not start a business to semenge ujama yuko ama tumjui, other than to semenge haya unakuanga bado. You know, that's bad.
That is a very bad image to have.
Saulika, you're not seen. But people that have always been consistent, that's why you find big companies like Safaricom, they're doing adverts consistently. And they're investing in that so that they may be able to recur in the minds and image of people.
That
so
is the importance of branding right there.
That's the importance
you
of
stick
branding.
In the minds of the people.
Of the people. Right. And most of for us, let's say in small scale, make sure that you have your guys in t-shirts. Like what I do, mostly if I have weddings, and I may not have a bigger budget, but I brand my guys. I make sure they are in t-shirts, they are in logos, they have the GNG. Atakama, I've carried another personnel that I train. Kwa jama lazima kipita pita tu hapo, akuwa amepiga brand juu chini.
So lazima, the lazima ukwe out there, lazima watu wakuone.
Yeah, lazima ukwe out there. Because actually now people don't call me Gibson, they call me GG.
Alright.
Most of them, they leave the G&G. But most of the guys that they have interacted, and most of them have not done anything with them, but ako GG, GG. That is something that I want to intensify.
All right. In the music industry, there's something we call over marketing. In other fields, do we have something like over marketing?
Yes, which is negative and positive at the same time. Negative because you don't want to bore people, and positive because it can improve your brand. But the over marketing, it depends. What are you marketing also? Yes.
My fans wanauliza GG inamaanisha nini? GNG
inamaanisha GNG, GNG, jina yangu ni Gibson. The other G, it's a story for another day.
All right, maybe go website to chopa kwa website.
Website. Now I'm on social media. I'm doing the website. I'm doing restructuring. I had it. So I'm doing restructuring because there's something new that I'm coming up.
How can they catch you on social media?
Social media, GNG Creations. Facebook, GNG Creations. Instagram, also GNG Creations.
GNG Creations everywhere.
Everywhere.
GNG Creations everywhere. So you are the co-founder.
Yep.
And you're moving. So there's this guy called Jeff Bezos, if you know him, the Amazon guy.
The Amazon, yeah.
Yes, he said that in business, the first day is always the most important. Because the first day is the day that you introduce your product to the people, is the day that what is going to spread, is the day that opinions are going to be built. What's your take on the first day of business?
The first day. Mm-hmm. The first day, it's a very important day. Mm-hmm. And mostly the first day is the visionary day.
Mm-hmm.
A day that you have started a journey, mm-hmm. what people call 1,000 miles,
mm-hmm.
but you can also surpass the 1,000 miles and keep going.
Uh-huh.
Because we have guys that have been there consistently because they showed up on the first day.
Uh-huh.
And that is the most important thing.
So the first day is very important.
It's very important.
As a business person.
Yeah.
When you're opening shop,
yes.
Show me a picture.
Show me a picture. Brand kabisa, tokea pale inje. Because I started from my own room.
Uh-huh.
Then we came up with the vision. Actually, my first logo ilikuanga handwritten.
Uh-huh.
And then when we decided now to go to the market,
mm-hmm.
we took a handy kasafit.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
So the first day is very important.
It's very important.
And you agree. All right. So I'd like to take you to the other side, where you say that you're trying to help other guys, other creatives, monetize their craft and their visions. How does this work, and how do you make this work?
The creatives has been, creatives department, or rather the creatives industry, has been mm-hmm. one thing. It has been there, people have tapped into it, but there's still a bigger gap where mm-hmm. we have young people that have not been able to completely explore their full potential,
mm-hmm.
which is something I came and partnered with Peak Performance mm-hmm. International, because they help us through the mindset change. Mm-hmm. They help the young people and even people all forms of and levels of life
mm-hmm.
to tap and monetize their potential.
Mm-hmm.
So for me, this is bigger than just me.
Mm-hmm.
And for that young person to grow understanding that there's something that I can, there's a passion that I have that I can monetize.
Mm-hmm.
Because when you don't have money, you cannot accelerate your passion and mm-hmm. do whatever you want.
Mm-hmm.
Easy stuff, many of the people that are Kwambia cameras, they're expensive. So you can't be saying you're a camera person, no one do a quick buy. So, and I've seen there's a bigger gap
uh-huh.
in terms of, most of the times I saw an hitting the inbox and I'm okay and the event here next, usikose kunibe. Okay and the event here next, usikose kunibe. But that means a bigger budget for me.
Uh-huh.
But if I show them how to do it, because what I've done, I came up with several of guys that they've seen me grow
uh-huh.
and I've one way or the other accelerated their growth.
Uh-huh.
And namwambia usikam kuhasolia jiji ukona tembea kutoka Madare hadi Tao. For like almost a whole year,
mm-hmm.
when you have an opportunity in Bungoma,
mm-hmm.
where you can tap. So by the time city takuita time yake,
mm-hmm.
so by the time yenye uko umetoka chuo, there's nothing that you're doing. Go to your people that know you and tell them. Unajua sahi most of the times ukienda home kama ufanya journalism, watu wasemanga ule mse wa TV. So if you have an opportunity, you can market. See, mina come to naku support.
Uh-huh.
We build your brand there,
uh-huh.
and after that, you can be a big name there, and you can easily come
each and every place. Spread out now.
And that's the thing that I'm really working towards, and that's the potential that I want to inspire in people.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
And the county governments have made it easier to go back to our rural homes and just invest there and do business.
Exactly.
All right. That is a wonderful message right there, and that is what you're supporting.
That is what I'm supporting.
Mm-hmm.
Scripture says, whatsoever your hand findeth to do, uh-huh. do it with all diligence.
All right.
Not where you find it, but whatsoever. Whatever you find in your hands mm-hmm. to do, you do with all diligence. All
right.
And that will be blessed.
You seem to be a spiritual person.
Yes.
You believe in God.
Yeah.
Is this a
that's
big part?
Why is this that's a big part God.
Of business?
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Because everything, you have to connect it to your creator.
Uh-huh.
And if that is what has given me to do, then it's an opportunity just to share it out there.
Wonderful. If anybody would like to work with GNG or Peak, tell them how they can find you guys online. Don't forget the business numbers. Yep. And don't forget to tell them how they can get to see some of your work as well.
Yes. On our social media platforms, we have all our work that we share, of course, with the permission with the clients. 0742-344-165 is the official number that they can get to us, and we work together.
All right. I have a feeling that I know the answer you're going to give me for this question, but I still ask. So the question is, what we posted on Facebook. Do you think social media has provided business opportunities for the youth, or it is imuharibu kitabia ama kimaadili?
I may say, otherwise, before I answer, digital is the next big thing. And anybody that will not tap into it will be left out. It will become irrelevant. To answer the question is, for some, like us, it has provided an opportunity to expand and
like
grow.
Like you are a testimony.
I am a testimony of that. But for others, you know, YouTube, porn, all this, it may destroy. And also we have people that are recurring from the effects of social media. They go to rehab, they're wasting a lot of money because it started all just by a click on the social media. So for some, yes, it has have negative, because the social media is a two-edged knife. One in a kata, huku ingine in a jenga. Yes, for some, it has have very negative impacts depending on how they have used it, but some have really used. Business are tapping into millions because of social media.
Wonderful. Thank you very much for the message.
Thank you
so
much.
We have a message from Mr. Gibson himself, the co-founder of GNG.
Yes.
All right. I'll give you one last chance. Remind them how they can find you on social media.
Yes. GNG Creations on all our handles. Twitter, it's Gibson Gome Creatives. GNG Creations Facebook. GNG Creations Instagram. And our numbers are 0742-344-165.
Thank you very much for coming, and thank you very much for what you're doing for the young people, and thank you for the message you're preaching.
Yes.
We appreciate you.
Thank you so much.
All right, we have come to the end of this. We had Gibson, and you had his message. You don't have to grind in the city of Nairobi. There are so many opportunities outside Nairobi. And he has said also that social media is a double-edged sword. For him, it has helped him make a lot of money. And for some people, people are in and out of rehab because of social media. So choose one side. Do you want to make money off it, or do you, or would you like to be in and out of rehab, as Gibson said? So we have our SMS line right there below the screen. You start with Y254 if you'd like to send us an SMS. Y254 on Facebook. 2015 is the SMS line. Start with Y254. Y254 on Facebook, Y254 channel on Twitter, and Y254_channel on Instagram. And mine is @itsbarrymore. Don't go nowhere. Don't touch that dial.